Hello guys, Bashar here with another Slay the Spire video. If you are curious about the newfound love about Slay the Spire, thing is, they have announced, Megacrit Games has announced that they will be adding a fourth character to the game for free. So, like I said, and the game has almost infinite replayability, guys. There are people that have poured thousands of hours in the game. I myself have poured a few hundreds, and it's quite fun. And like I said, infinite replayability. You will, if you like the game, you will never get tired of out of it, because every time you do it, it's a new challenge, and sometimes you get quite unlucky. And trying to win those are quite fun. So that's it. So in this video, guys, we will be discussing the achievements. I quite like achievements myself, and for those of you other achievers out there, I will go over the achievements. Some of them are, of course, quite easy. We will go in descending order of difficulty, and by difficulty I mean the percentage of players who have completed those achievements. So the first achievement that we will discuss will be the achievement that was done, that was completed by the most players, and the 44th will be the one that is completed by the least players. So for the first achievement, for the first three achievements, guys, we can, I think, handle them all together. It's killing the chapter one bosses, guys. So as you know, when you start the game, at the end of, doesn't really matter, okay, at the end of the act, there are three bosses. The first one is the Guardian. That's the easiest achievement. That's the achievement that's completed by most people, defeating the Guardian. The second is the Ghost, the Hexa Ghost. And the third one is the Slime Boss, guys. These are the first three achievements. For the fourth, fifth, and sixth achievement, guys, killing the act two bosses are coming next. The Champ, the Bronze Automaton, and the Collector, those are the 4th, 5th, and 6th achievements respectively, completed by the percentage of the players. So these will occur naturally. So if you are recently starting playing Slay the Spire, I mean, do not pay special effort for these achievements. They will occur naturally. I mean, you will play the game, you will get those bosses, and you will beat them, and you will get those achievements. And that's why the completion rate is so high for those. So the seventh achievement is Shrug It Off. It consists of winning a battle with only one HP remaining. Guys, I mean, you can force this achievement and get it on your own. Just engage a non-scaling easy enemy in Act 1 and just wait till you get low HP and use your block abilities, blah blah, to go down to 1 HP and beat the monsters and get the achievement. But it will occur naturally. I mean, do not pay special effort for it. The 8th achievement is Ascent Zero, which consists of unlocking Ascension mode. That used to be harder, but now I think it consists of finishing the game only. I am actually not exactly sure how it goes. Okay, I said, okay, it wants me to select the room. Okay, let's just abandon run. So, like I said, I am, might be wrong here, but I think it's just finishing the game. It was much worse back then. I think you need to kill all three bosses, all three end bosses of the game to unlock it, I think. So the next achievement is Plague. Defeat three enemies with poison in a single combat, and for that we need the Silent Guy, guys. So she does poison damage if you get the poison cards, and You just have to finish off three enemies with poison. So guys, just use your block cards, just use your poison, and let the poison finish off the monsters. I mean, you can do this easily after getting a few poison cards in the middle of chapter one. I mean, this will also naturally occur when you're playing the silent with a poison build. This will naturally occur as well. The next achievement in line is the pact. That consists of exhausting 20 cards. This is best done. It will also naturally occur, guys. It is best done when fighting the Act 1 elite sentries, because those sentries turn 1, the two ones in the outer sides will give you 4 days, and then they will attack, and the other one in the middle give you 2 days, and days are ethereal, so they will auto exhaust themselves. And if that combat lasts long, after exhausting 20 days, you will get the achievement. And that's probably how most people who have the achievement have done it. The next achievement in line is having 9 energy in a single turn. Well, for that, there are some relics and some cards that give energy. I mean, if you get some... I mean, there are boss relics out there that give you extra energy, guys, as you can see. There are quite a few, and there are some relics that give you extra energy under special conditions like this. So if you draw your entire deck 3 times, it gives you 2 energy, and there are some cards that give energy as well. Using all of these in conjunction can get you 9 energy. As I keep saying, this also will naturally occur. And the next achievement in line is beating the game with the Ironclad, guys. That's most people have a completion with Ironclad, because guys, it's the default class. It's like the mage in Hearthstone, right? The default class, because people start the game with that and they have some sort of affinity with that class and they don't want to change, and that's why they keep pushing with Ironclad. And of course, experience leads to beating the game. So that's why Ruby, the beating the game with the Ironclad, has the highest ratio. Next up, we have perfect, defeat a boss without taking any damage. That's so popular. I mean, that's so easily obtained because guys, during the act 3 there is an event that lets you fight an act 1 boss, and in act 3 you are already so strong you can actually easily defeat an act 1 boss without taking any damage. So that's why so many people have this. This actually would be much harder if it was about endgame bosses only. So next up, we have the 3 act 3 bosses, Dono and Deka, the shapes, the Crow, the Awakened One, and the Time Eater. That's the Time Eater anyway. I mean, the achievement's name and the boss's name are one and the same. So the finishing beating these also has an achievement. And then we have Come At Me, which means winning a combat without playing any attacks. Well, that's done easily with silent, guys, because if you are playing a poison build with silent, the most of the poison cards are skills, not attacks. There are a few attacks that add poison as well, but most of the time they are skills. And if you are playing a poison build, you defend yourself with skills, you use poison cards, those are also skills, so you can win a combat without playing a single attack. That's easy. And the next achievement in line is beating the game with silent. That's the second character. And we slowly are getting to the point of relatively harder achievements, guys. The next achievement is having 99 or more poison on a single enemy. That's done with the help of, I mean, you can reach it, of course, but thing is, guys, unless the enemy has a lot of HP, gathering that much poison is hard, so you use Catalyst. Catalyst is a card that lets you double and triple when it's upgraded. Catalyst is an uncommon or rare. Yeah, there it is. So guys, when it's upgraded, it triples the enemy's poison, and when it's not upgraded, it doubles. So you give a little bit of poison to the enemy, and then with Catalyst you triple it, and that's how you can reach 99 or more poison. So guys, if the monster has 33 poison, that works. Or you could just burst and play double Catalyst, or just play double Catalyst, guys, because the double Catalyst upgraded gives 9 times the poison. So the enemy has 11 poison, you Catalyst it, it becomes 33, and you Catalyst it again, and it becomes 99, yielding the giving you the achievement. So this also will naturally occur when you are playing a poison build with Catalyst. Then next up we have the Ironclad version of it. Obtain 99 block during a single combat. So that's best done with a barricade, of course, guys. Barricade prevents your block from getting removed at the start of your turn. And if you have a defensive deck, which you should with barricade, you will get there eventually. Or you could play some cards that give a lot of block, like Impervious or some other cards, and then use where is it? Can find it. Entrench to double your block and get there. I mean, this will also happen eventually. There's no need to worry about it. And the next achievement is Sapphire, beat the game with defect. Sapphire has a lower completion ratio because, guys, the game came out with Ironclad and the game was in early access at the end of 2017 or something, guys, somewhere like that, sometime like that, and the defect was added later in the game, like 6 months later or so, in the middle of 2018 or so. So that's why many people got used to those two and didn't play much with defect. Next up we have Powerful. Powerful is getting 10 or more buffs during combat. So Strength is a buff, Dexterity is a buff, Focus is a buff. For example, Metallicize at the end of your turn, gain 3 or 4 block, whatever, is a buff. And even Flex gives you 2 buffs because it gives you the Strength, and it gives you the, at the end of your turn, lose 2 strength buff, guys. That's a buff too. I mean, that doesn't count as a debuff. So weak is a buff. So the game's understanding of buffs works. If something is displayed beneath your character, that's a buff. So you need to have 10 of these. You could use some potions for it. You could use Flex or some stuff like it. You could use some relics. I mean, this will occur eventually, guys. It's not very, very hard. Yeah. For example, Rage is a buff because whenever you play an attack, you gain 3 block, right? That needs to be displayed. So when you play Rage, you get a buff. Or when you play Rupture, you get a buff. So guys, just try to get like 6 or 7 and then use a few potions, and it will occur as well, naturally. This used to be actually harder, but they added more stuff that adds buffs, so it's now easy. And the next one is My Lucky Day. You have to finish a daily climb, and the daily climb has specific rules. You just say embark guys and you finish the map and you are done. Purity is next achievement. Have three or fewer cards in your hand, in your draw and in your discard pile combined. But guys, getting a deck with three cards is almost impossible. So the method you should be pursuing is to exhaust your deck. So let me show you. For example, this card is great for it. True Grit. And it's upgrade. So the amount of it blocks, the amount of block it gives is just 9 from 7, but it doesn't exhaust a random card, but at a card you choose. So guys, using True Grit, you will exhaust your strikes, defense, whatever cards. Just leave one offensive card and like two True Grits in your deck. And find a non-scaling enemy like a slime and just keep tanking him till you have three cards remaining. And in the end, finish him off with an attack and the achievement will be complete. So this is the first achievement that you actually have to work for, guys. I mean, this will not naturally occur, but it's not hard to do. So I mean, it can naturally occur as well, but it will be rarer. So next achievement is Jaxed. You need to have 50 or more strength during combat. That's best done with Ironclad, obviously, because strength is Ironclad's forte. That's a nice thing there. And the card that we will use is Limit Break, guys. Normally, it doubles your our strength and exhaust, but when it's upgraded, it doesn't get exhausted. So just get one or two strength and just keep playing Limit Break while tanking your opponent. Like I said, a non-scaling enemy like a slime. Just tank it and play Limit Break. I mean, you can even start from one strength, but it will go much slower. If you start from two strength, you will get to 4, 8, right? Because it doubles. Your base is getting doubled. So 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. You could, of course, get demon form and wait 17 turns. But this is much, much faster. And when you are playing a strength ironclad deck, this also will occur naturally. So next up, we have Infinity. Play 25 cards in a single turn. This is best done with, let me show you, with this, guys. So with Unceasing Tap, if you play all your cards, it lets you draw a card. And there are specific decks, guys, that you can make sometimes that consists of mostly zero cost cards. And you just spend your hand and you keep playing the cards from your deck. And every time you use a card, Unceasing Tap gives you another. I mean, going literally infinite is very hard, but guys, you can have a deck with the average cost very close to zero. I mean, you remove your strikes, you remove your defense, and you get some cards that give you energy, you get some relics that give you energy, and you can actually play a lot of cards during in a single turn. And there are, of course, cards like this in silent that make you play a lot of cards. I'm gonna upgrade it. For example, guys, where is that card? This gives you two shifts. So you play Cloak and Dagger, you actually play the two shifts because shifts are free. So you play three cards for one energy. With this, you play four cards for one energy. So that's how it goes, guys. I mean, you could use your energy potions, etc. I mean, you can just use your extra resources to achieve that. But in a shift deck, it's not very hard to do. Of course, you can do an infinite deck with the top I showed. So the next achievement is very similar, guys. Play 10 shifts in a single turn. Well, guys, just blade what was the name of that card? Burst, right? Burst. Let me find it. Yes, Burst. Just Burst Blade Dance, and you will get 6 shears. And there is a relic that gives you 3 shears at the beginning of combat, and Cloak and Dagger. So if you are playing a shiv deck, you should be able to get multiple shivs. And guys, you can do some cheap tricks like getting the shivs in your hand and not playing them if you have a very draw oriented deck. And once you, for example guys, you draw like 3 or 4 shivs from your deck and a few other cards, then you can use some extra draw to fill your hand and then play all of your shivs at once and get that done. The next achievement is having 999 block during combat, guys. And believe it or not, you don't actually need to have barricade. Of course, it helps tremendously. That is the card that will help you get 999 block. But there is a very lame combo that allows you to get there, but you will have to grind for 40 minutes or so. Let me show you Metallicize, guys. And let me find it. Where is it? Dual Wield, I think that was the name. Yes, Metallicize. Dual Wield, yes, guys. So, Dual Wield duplicates an attack or power card. When it's upgraded, it actually gives you 2 copies. So, you get a deck with Dual Wield and Metallicize, guys. You get an enemy that's non-scaling, like slimes as always, or the curling up monsters. So you play Dual Wield on your Metallicize, and you actually get 2 more Metallicizes in your hand, and then you play your Metallicizes, and after playing 250 upgrade Metallicizes, guys, you will get the achievement. But like I said, this is pathetic, and this is how I did it, by the way. I mean, it was one of my last achievements. I didn't get lucky with my barrier builds back then, and so that's how I did it. And it takes around 40 to 45 minutes, guys, if your deck is not small. My deck wasn't small. I mean, I had strikes and defense in it, so I kept playing Dual Wield, Metallicize, Dual Wield, Metallicize 250 times, guys. And you cannot do it every single turn either, so it wasn't fun. But this is how it can be done, and this is the normal way, guys. Just barricade, gather a nice amount of block, entrench a few times, and it gets done. So the next achievement, that's actually surprising, guys. That's a hard achievement. You have to defeat a boss on turn 1. That Act 3 event is helping there. In the Act 3 event, guys, you are given the option to fight a Act 1 boss in return for a rare relic, and you are given a few more options. But like I said, in Act 3 you are so strong, guys. Act 1 bosses are like a joke, and if you are strong enough, you can even take the boss down on turn 1. And slime boss is only 140 HP, guys. I mean, that can be done without huge problems. So I guess that's, because normally, guys, it's not very easy, and you can do it with infinite decks as well. I mean, if you have a deck that plays many cards, by infinite, I mean not literally infinite, but close to infinite, guys. I mean, if you can play like 20-30 cards in your first turn, that's as close as it gets, and that can kill a boss. So next up, we have Ascend 10. That means completing a game in Ascension 10. And as you know, you have to do them one by one. So you have to finish the regular game first, unlock Ascension, Ascension 1, Ascension 2, Ascension 3. And these are kept separately on all characters. You cannot do Ascension 1, 2, 3 on Ironclad, and then 4 and 5 on Silent, and go back 6 to Ironclad. That doesn't work. You have to do it separately. So completing Ascension 10 requires at least finishing the game 11 times, guys. And it won't work like that, of course. It will be much harder. So next up, we have complete the ending with the Ironclad Ruby Plus. That means finishing Act 4, guys. We have discussed it in the introduction. When you are playing the game, Let's just do it again. I will show it to you. Okay. Okay, doesn't matter. Okay. In here you see a key here, guys. Killing these flashy elites, there are one in each act. You have to kill just one, gives you a key fragment. I think it's the blue one. And skipping a rest site, by skipping, I mean not literally skipping, but when you go into a rest site, you get an option, okay, to recall. Okay, let's just do it quickly. Let me show you. It's easy anyway. Okay, you need to restart, doesn't matter. This is because of the power up that we used at the beginning of the game. Iron layer, doesn't matter. Okay, doesn't. We got the bag of prep. Okay, now we are entering the. Okay, see guys, we get the option to rest that heals 30% of our max life. We get the option to upgrade a card, and if we do not choose those and the other options that are available to us, we can choose the recall, and recall will give us the red key fragment. And the final fragment, one of them is the Sparky Elites, the other is from skipping a rest site, and the final part is obtained from skipping these chests, guys. As you know, you guaranteed get a chest every act, and if you do not get the relic in there, you are given the option to pick the green key piece that will give you the green key piece, as I said. So the red key piece from skipping rest sites, the green piece from the chest, or might be the blue maybe, and the blue from the flash elites, and you will complete the key. And if you manage to finish the game with a complete key, and that means completing act 3, you will be taken to act 4. There you will fight a specific elite. It's a bit hard, and then you will find you will fight the heart. That's pretty hard, guys. I mean, it's okay on lower ascensions, but on higher ascensions, I mean, the combined difficulty becomes quite a lot. It's pretty hard. So that's what the achievement is about. So completing the ending means completing act 4 with Ironclad. Next achievement is killing the transient before it fades away. The transient is a random encounter in act 3, in chapter 3, guys, and he has 999 HP, and he does you increasing damage, huge damage, but he also loses one strength per damage you inflict upon him, so you can just nuke him and do not worry about it. But the damage is pretty great. I think he does 40, 50, 60, 70, and 80 damage and then dies. Varies with ascension levels, of course. So he needs stays for about 5 turns. For 5 turns, so you need to do about 200 damage per turn. You could set up an infinite deck and just nuke him on the last turn, or you could, I mean, to your heart's content, guys, but it's not very, very easy. To deal that much damage, you have to have an offensive deck, and you of course have to find the transient. I am actually surprised that the ratio of players, 7.8% of the players have this achievement. I think it's high, because this was pretty annoying for me. I had to build an infinite deck, guys. Let me show you. Okay, where is it? Okay. Where is it? Oh, I had this card in my deck, and I had dual wield. That gives me 2 extra copies of these. I dual wielded this. I had some powers, and as you know, powers are played when powers are played, you do not draw them again. I played some of my powers, and I also exhausted some of my cards in those four turns. And finally, guys, I managed to get a 11 card deck. And as you know, you cannot hold more than 10 cards in your hand. So I drew 5 cards and I drew the rest of my deck. And my final situation was, guys, 9 cards in hand, a Flash of Steel in hand, and a Flash of Steel in discard pile. So you play the Flash of Steel. There's nothing in your draw pile, so your discard pile becomes your draw pile. You draw that Flash of Steel. The other Flash of Steel goes to your discard pile. Boom, 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 infinite Flash of Steels. And that's how I managed it. So, next up we have Emerald Plus, which means completing the ending with the Silent. Finish Act 4 with the Silent. And for this, I mean, this stuff is relatively easy, but it's not very easy, guys. You might have to work a bit. The next achievement is O Donut, which means killing the Act 3 Donut and Deka. You have to leave the Donut last. You have to kill Deka, and you will have to feed on the Donut, guys. So you have to make the final blow with this one. I mean, if you have nice damage, you can just nuke that and tank the other till you can finish it off with the feed. It's not extremely easy, but on low ascensions it can be done. The next achievement is Sapphire Plus, completing the ending with the defect. So guys, these statistics lead me to believe that there are actually a lot of players who go for achievements in Slay the Spire, because I mean, these achievements do not occur naturally. I mean, you have to pursue, right? I mean, completing Act 4, well, it doesn't require any ascension levels at least, but still it's not very easy. Speed Climber is the next achievement, finishing the game in under 20 minutes, guys. Ironclad is the best speedrunner. Just this card is your friend, guys. This card is very good at taking everything down. Its upgraded version deals 8 damage to all enemies, by the way. And if you get an energy relic from the Act 1 boss, it will become doing 32 damage to all enemies, and that can wipe fights instantly. So just go for the Whirlwind Ironclad build and get a basic grip of the basic understanding of the game, and you will be able to manage to finish the game in 20 minutes. I mean, maybe you will need a medium level of understanding of the game, guys, because finishing the game in the first few tries can be hard. So if you manage to finish the game regularly, then you can try this one. But like I said, these do not require any ascension, so they are not very, very hard. So completing Act 4 with all classes is the end. That's the next achievement. And we are almost at the bottom of our list, guys. Next is having 25 or more focus during combat. That's That's the defect achievement, guys. There are a few cards that give you focus, so you can use those. Defragment gives you +2 focus. This can help you pretty much, guys. Gives you 5 focus, and you can actually use Amplify on it. That will make it play twice. Because, guys, you have to hit 25 focus only momentarily. I mean, you don't have to keep it. So, I mean, it's hard to reach because it's hard to get there because both are rares, but if you amplify 2 bias cognitions, that's 20 focus already. It's a bit hard to get down, but there are a lot of stuff that gives you focus, guys. And you can play this card and get rid of the debuff, guys. For example, you can get an artifact from Core Surge, you can get an artifact from the potion, and that will prevent you from losing focus. And there are decks out there with you can make decks like with 4 defrags, 5 defrags, and there are potions that also give focus, guys. So and there are also relics that give focus too. Was there anything else that can help? Oh, that's it, yeah. I forgot about it. That's how I did it, yeah. Because guys, those cards are powers and they are not, they cannot be abused indefinitely. This card is the thing, guys. So, consume will helps you gain 3 focus and makes you lose an orb slot. Well, you do not care about the orb slot because you just want 25 focus, guys. So, you just find a non-scaling enemy as usual. Just you do use consume. I'm not sure how it works when you have just 1 orb slot, but I think it doesn't take away your last orb slot. So I mean you can do it, I think. So just spam consume, I mean tank it and consume. Just 1 frost orb would be enough, guys, because I mean with high focus it will give you a lot of block. I think it doesn't take away your final orb slot. Yeah, that's how it should be done. I mean with defrag and bias cognition it would be very very hard because 25 is quite high, so consume is the way to go. Next up we have neon that requires us to channel 9 plasma orbs in a single turn. That's a bad achievement, guys. I don't like it because it actually almost requires you to have that single card. You need meteor strike, guys, and meteor strike allows you to channel 3 plasma. And as you can see, the cost is 5, so it's horrible. Normally, you wouldn't be able to do it, but you could use Snake Eye for randomized cost, or you could use Enlightenment, I think that was the name. Enlightenment, yes. Enlightenment, you change the cost of cards in our hand to 1, not for just that turn, but for the entirety of that combat. So, get 1 or 2 meteor strikes and use enlightenment on it, or like I said Sneko. And defect has a very good card that makes this achievement possible, guys. You have hologram that allows you to get a card from your discard pile back to your hand. So get 1 or 2 meteor strikes and as many holograms as you can, and in the discard pile it remembers its low cost, guys. So if you get a 1 or 0 cost meteor strike or even 2, just cast the meteor strike, you will channel 3 plasma, you get it back from your discard pile, do it again, and those plasmas will be evoked and you will get 6 energy back, and then it will be over, right? So and without that, it without meteor strike it's extremely hard, guys, because there are not many cards that channel plasma even. For example, let me see. There is a card that channels 1 plasma, I remember. I think its cost was 1 when it's upgraded. Yes, fusion, guys. I mean, how would you play fusion 9 times in a single turn? And there is another card that channels 2 random orbs. And guys, there are 4 orbs, so this has a 50% chance of giving you plasma, which is impossible. So I mean, maybe it has been done few times, but I mean, most of the people who did it with Meteor Strike, obviously. I'll get the door and be right back. Sorry about that. So finally, we have Minimalist. That's a very hard achievement, guys. Finishing the game with a 5 or smaller deck. Guys, in here you definitely want Ironclad because that's a hard one. So Ironclad has the added benefit of having Bash in the deck. And why is Bash good, guys? Bash is good because you have, where is it? I'm gonna find it. Is it an uncommon then? Yes, Dropkick, guys. So take a look at the combo. you bash the enemy and it becomes vulnerable, then you play dropkick, and dropkick becomes free if the enemy is vulnerable, right? So if you can manage to get multiple dropkicks or copy it with dual wield guys, and if you manage to draw your entire deck and play a dropkick, and the only card in your discard pile is a dropkick, you will draw the other dropkick, and dropkick, 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 you'll go infinite, and that's a working combo. Because guys, getting five cards is a challenge, and getting a viable deck that can finish the game with five cards is another challenge. Because guys, you are not allowed to exhaust cards in the final combat and get the achievement. That doesn't work. The deck list, let me show, the deck list on the upper right has to be five cards. That is the problem. So, and I think also Ironclad has the smallest starting deck as well. Let me see. Yeah, 10 cards, guys. So the Silent has 12, right? We do not want 12 cards, because getting to 5 is very hard, guys. You have to get to every merchant and remove a card. And as you know, it gets more expensive every time you remove it, and that will cost a lot of gold. And you also need to get like a few cards to make the combo, right? For example, guys, I keep bash, and I will have to get 2 drop kicks, or I will have to get a drop kick and a dual wield, and that's not enough to go infinite, right? Because I draw only 5 cards per turn. So for my deck is 5 cards, that's enough to go infinite, because first turn I will play bash and dual wield the drop kick, and then I will play the drop kick, and that drop kick will go to my graveyard. I mean, the first turn I might miss, but the second turn I will definitely be able to go infinite, guys. So you need to draw, you need to remove at least 5 cards, and you will, since you will add a few cards, you will have to remove another card for each card that you add in your deck, guys. So at the bare minimum, you will have to add 2 drop kicks or a drop kick and a dual wield. That means removing 7 cards, guys. So you have to be lucky with the events as well. Or you could just dual wield the colorless card that I just showed you, the Flash of Steel, 0 damage, 0 mana, deal some damage, draw a card. That's very good, guys. Okay, wrong. Flash of Steel. Yes, this one. I mean, just dual wield that one. And if you can draw your entire deck and you have 2 Flash of Steels in your hand, boom, 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 infinite Flash of Steel. And do not worry about creating copies with Flash of Steel, guys, because the achievement only takes into account your entire deck on the upper right. So the next achievement, achievement number 41, is Ascension 20. Complete the game on Ascension 20. That's pretty hard, guys, because you will have all the combined difficulty of all the previous ascensions, and you will have to beat 2 final bosses without any healing. That's pretty hard. And next up, we have the Common Sense achievement. That means finishing the game without any uncommons or rares in the deck. So we are allowed to have curses, and we are allowed to have commons. So just take a look at this border, guys. If it's blue or if it's golden, you are not allowed to take it. So, well, I'm gonna go with Ironclad again, because it's default class and I like it as well. So you can go for a perfect strike build, guys. Just take anything that has the name strike on it, and your perfect strike will do huge damage. Or you can do a heavy blade build, guys, because you are allowed to have relics. Relics are not a problem. And get every single Shragitov for defense. That will work out. Or you can do a poison or Shiv silent. Just be careful about the rarity, guys. And One thing, guys, for example, you have a nice common deck and you are getting towards the end and an event comes and gives you accuracy. That's annoying, I know. For example, the imp event that makes you reveal cards. Even if your first two reveals are the same card, that will get added to your deck, right? You can remove it on a shop because the game just checks your deck after you have beaten the game, guys. I mean, if you had some uncommons or rares at some point, that doesn't matter. You just have to not have anything other than curses and commons in your deck by the time you finish the game. So, I mean, I had this achievement fail a few times because some events gave me some cards. That's very annoying, I know. Nothing can be done though. So, and the final achievement, it's not the final achievement, but you will understand why I refer it to that. 2% of the people have done it. Finishing the game with a single relic, guys. That's a bit tough because you have to skip everything. It's a good idea to replace your starting relic, guys. So when you begin the game, the fourth option that is presented to you by Neo, if you get to the boss, is always to replacing your starting relic with a boss relic. Normally that's not worth it because the starting relic is very nice, but when you are stuck with a single relic, guys, the boss relic can be fine. And Snake Eye is especially powerful because, you know, it makes you draw two extra cards and randomizes all of your costs. And if you begin the game with Snake Eye, you just pick everything that's high costed, because I mean the randomized cost can be anything from 0 to 3, so the average cost is 1.5. So if you are getting 2 or 3 energy cards, you are actually saving energy by getting those. So, I mean, the lamest way to do it would be to start the game, get to act boss, concede, replace your initial relic. And if you get a Snekko, just force the game. I mean, you can do it with an energy relic as well, but it will be harder. Snekko works. And the final achievement is getting all the other achievements. I think it's a bit of bad design because, I mean, they will add the fourth character now and they will add some more achievements to the game, but this achievement will be already obtained by a lot of players, and that's 0.5% of the players, guys, the obtain all the achievements. But that was recently added to the game, so there are people out there with all the achievements, I think, that haven't logged in to get that one. So that's the last achievement. If you have any questions regarding any achievements, guys, feel free to ask. I did my best to explain to you, but I might have skipped something, or maybe something was not clear. Feel free to ask. See you. Good night.